Hello everyone, I am Sanjeev Panday and today this is video 1 on the poem A Photograph written by Shirley Tolson. First of all, look at the title. The title of the poem is A Photograph. A photograph is the product of a camera that captures a scene, an event, an incident of a particular time. But it can't capture time. Time passes away. Human life is very short in comparison to that of nature. Human life is very short in comparison to that of nature. The life of natural objects is more than human life. For example, rivers, mountains, oceans, seas, rocks, earth, heavenly bodies, etc. are more permanent than human life. Human life is nothing in front of them. Human will come on this earth. After some time they will go after death. But these natural objects will remain. This is the basic point of the poem. Now come to the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and see the big girl, some 12 years or so. All these stood still to smile through their air at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, vast, their terribly transient feet. Now see, actually the poet is looking a cardboard picture. In that picture, there is a photograph. In that photograph, three girls are there. One is the poet's mother, and other two are poet's mother's cousin. Poet's mother's cousin, and the background is sea. Actually, when the poet's mother was nearly 12 years old, she with her cousins went to seashore on a holiday with their uncle. An uncle took the photograph, and at this time the poetess is looking at the photograph. Now see, the cardboard shows me how it was when the cardboard picture shows the poet how it was when the two girl's cousin. Two girl's cousin means the cousins of the poet's mother. Bent paddling on the seashore. They were paddling in the water of the sea. They were walking unsteadily through the water on the seashore. And each girl holding one of my mother's hand. And each girl was holding the poet's mother's hand. One on one side and second on the other side. And see the big girl. She means the mother, the big girl. And see the poet's mother was the eldest girl. Some 12 years or so. And at the time, her age was nearly 12 years old. She was nearly 12 years old or something around it. See the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their ear and see. Actually, they were on the seashore and they were smiling. And their ear was flying over their faces. And they were smiling through their ear. See the line. All three. Poet's mother and poet's mother's cousins were standing. Still means motionless. They were not moving. Still means motionless. All three girls were standing motionless to smile. To smile through their ears. Actually, their uncle told them to stand motionless for a pose. And that's why they were standing motionless and they were smiling through their flying ears. At the uncle with the camera, and they were looking at uncle and they were smiling at the uncle who was ready with his camera to click the picture. Now what a beautiful picture was. What a beautiful picture was. A sweet face. And the face of the poet's mother was very lovely, was very beautiful. It was a very sweet face. A sweet face, my mother's. The poet is looking at the photograph. In that photograph, she finds that her mother's face was very sweet, was very beautiful. That was before I was born. And see, that was before the birth of poet. Means to say that poet's mother face was very beautiful before the birth of the poet. And the sea that was also captured in the photograph. The sea which appears to have changed less. See, mother had changed, her cousins have changed, but the sea has changed very less. Actually, there is no change in the sea. But human life has changed. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, which looks to have changed less, vast. Their table is very much transiently short-lived. Short-lived, not permanent, feet. And in that picture, the sea, everlasting sea, permanent sea, that looks to have changed very less. Badbasing, dear means the mother, mothers and cousins, transmits short-lived, changing feet. To see, their feet have changed, their body has changed, but the sea seems to have changed very less. What is the point? The point is human life changes faster than natural objects. Thank you. Have a nice day.